Bonjour bros, welcome to a different type of video that we have today on the channel. And guys, today we're gonna do a discussion video about a big FIFA 19 subject. So we received a lot of this question on Twitter, Instagram, and sometimes during our stream. The question is, bros, should I get FIFA points? Should I buy FIFA points? This will basically cost you potentially a lot of money.
Yeah, and real money. We ain't talking about a couple thousand coins on the game. Now we're talking about real money. The king question today is, should you buy FIFA points in FIFA 19, and especially in parentheses at the start of FIFA 19? So guys, just to let you know, just to clear up your mind, we are YouTubers. We can make a little bit of money while we post video on a platform called YouTube. Yeah. If you're just a casual gamer, you won't have any review from YouTube. You know what I mean? Yeah. So there is no need for you to put thousand upon thousand of euros, pounds or dollars into one single game if you don't make a revenue out of it. The second thing is that Liam and I are both working. We are working really hard outside of YouTube, so we have our own money. I just wanted to clear up your mind for this, bros. Basically, for us, we're not going to put any FIFA points at the start. We're going to explain you why. And to explain you why, we need to come back a year ago at the start of FIFA 18. So we wanted to have the best team possible for the start, for the first three champions of FIFA 18. So Liam and I, we decided to put each 50 euros. In total, we put it 100 euros at the start of FIFA 18 to open packs. Bros, at the start, the packed weight is crap. When I say it's crap, for 100 euros put into the game, the best player that we got, Smalling, Aurier, and Hugminson.
Yes.
Those were the best player we got. Bros, out of 100, for me 100 euros, it's 2 days of work, I got Hugminson, Smalling, and Aurier. Just to let you know, guys, at the start, packed weight is crap.
But we were super unlucky. I remember this video because we recorded that video with our dad. Yeah. Our dad opened our pack. Maybe that was because of our dad. He wasn't really lucky that day. But yes, in terms of value for coins, well, we lost a big time. We lost big time. But Vincent, sometimes FIFA points can be interesting at the start because you get a lot of consumables, a lot of contract, a lot of fitness cards and everything like this. Those are super important. So yes, we lost big times. But at the same time, we gained a little bit because after we didn't have to buy contract, we didn't have to buy fitness card, we didn't have to buy any healing cards. So there's positive and negative around that. And pack weight, I mean, let's be honest, more and more people are opening packs nowadays, so it's going to be harder for you guys to pack any big players, any icons. Just to let you know, in pack openings, sometimes big YouTubers spend hours opening packs. Okay, let's not forget about that. They spend hours to open packs, and they only take out like maybe 10 to 15 minutes of good packs.
And the positive aspect of you buying FIFA points at the start of FIFA 19 will be really easy, boys. You will have a lot of consumable, like Liam you said. Yeah. Those are really expensive at the start. Then second of all, this is a big topic, bros, right there. You will make trading easy.
Okay? Easier for you.
Easier Definitely. For you. Because Definitely. A lot of people, I know a lot of my friends, bros, in real life, they buy FIFA points at the start because they're not confident enough to do trading at the start of FIFA.
It's not really confidence, but it's as well the time. You know, the time is
confidence, time, you can rely those.
I mean,
but at the start,
if you work and everything, it's time. You know, it's
when
it's
I was important. Younger, and when I was younger, I wasn't confident to try to do some trading. So it was easier in my mind to say to myself, okay, let me put some FIFA points because I know that in trading, I'm not the best, basically, boys. So yeah, a lot of people will buy FIFA points to get coins, because like that will be their way of doing trading. By the way, guys, let me know if you want to put FIFA points, how much FIFA points will you spend into the start of FIFA 19, and how much FIFA points did you spend in overall throughout FIFA 19, depending whenever you watch this video. Two more things about positive aspect on FIFA points. You will have some coins to invest into the team of the week. One, the first team of the week. I remember in FIFA 18, brothers, to give you a clear example, the best player in the team of the week one was Antonio Valencia, the right back for Man United. He used to have an 84, 85 rated card in form at the start of FIFA 18. That card at the start was going for more or less 100,000 coins, which is a lot at the start. Not a lot of people can afford to pay Antonio Valencia in form for 100,000 coins. And I remember people sold that card in December/November more than 400,000 coins. This is just to let you know, guys, that if you can invest into the first team of the week, into some players of the first team of the week, and if you are being patient enough to keep them into your club and sell them at the correct moment, you will make a bank. This is a positive aspect of buying FIFA points. The last one is that, of course, brothers, opening packs, I think it's one of the best fun things to do in about FIFA. Yeah. Basically, when you open Ultimate Team, you want to have coins to open packs. And that will give you pleasure. And at the end of the day, playing a video game or playing a game is to give you pleasure.
Indeed, but Ultimate Team in a way is there's packs and there's Ultimate Team. Like, they go together. You know what I mean, Buzz? Without packs, Ultimate Team will not be the same thing. So you're grinding FUT Champions, you're grinding Squad Battle. This year, you'll be grinding FUT Rivals, FUT Division Rivals to get packs.
For me, guys, why do I love FIFA Ultimate Team so much? It's because of the grind. Because of working hard to get some coins. Guys, when you put 100 euros at the start of FIFA 18, for example, like we did, we lost that sense of grinding for coins mid-FIFA. Bros, this is a feeling I don't want to get again in FIFA 19. Bros, believe me, this is why we didn't upload it for couple months, for 2 months on the channel, because I lost the feeling of having fun playing FIFA because it was too easy for me to have millions of coins. This is why in FIFA 19, guys, I'm going to put shit all in terms of FIFA points. I want to put no money into FIFA points. I want to have that feeling of grinding for coins, you know? I want to have that feeling of telling to myself, oh, damn, I missed those 20,000 coins to buy the player I really need in my squad. For me, this is a priceless feeling to have whenever you play FIFA, brothers. Let me know down there if it's as well for you one of the most important things when you play FIFA, it's to have that sense of grinding.
So to be fair, you don't really need to be putting FIFA points if you know when to buy, when to sell.
And guys, in FIFA 19, there's a huge feature, a huge new feature. This is called Division Rivals. That'll be kind of like the FUT Champions, but only during the week. So that means we won't have to wait until FUT Champions to really have some big rewards. Division Rivals will be a good way for us, the casual gamer and the content creator on YouTube, just to have a really good team, or at least I will say a decent team, when the first few champions will come out, basically, guys. So you won't have to wait 2-3 weeks to have some really good packs. If you play a little bit of Division Rivals, you will get some decent pack at the first few days of FIFA. That means, to be fair, you can have a potential good after it depends on the pack, but you can have better chance of having a good team before the first few champions kickstart.
I mean, it's not really about the first few champions. I'm talking more about during the year in overall. I mean, right now in FIFA 19 at least, I know in FIFA 17 and FIFA 18 with few champions being introduced in FIFA 17 and in FIFA 18 squad battle at the start, right now, boys, it's literally so easy to make coins if you're grinding a little bit. I say a little bit the game. If you play maybe let's say you play entire FUT champions, you're decent at the game. You get gold. Gold 2, gold 1. If you're decent, I mean, more pretty good at the game, you get elite directly. Some of the packs you will get, they can make you millions of coins if you're a little bit lucky. You know, if you keep trying, if you keep grinding. In FIFA 19, if you literally play a couple games, a few games during the week.
We don't know yet.
We don't really know, but you'll get rewards. So right now in FIFA 19, there's at least 3 ways if you play the game and if you're good at the game, 3 different game modes where you can earn packs. That means coins. Then after there's SBCs. After there's FUT Draft. So there's as well 4 game modes with FUT Draft. You know, what can be interesting at the start of FIFA, then we didn't talk about the positive of putting any FIFA points at the start of the game at least, will be for the FUT Draft. Then if you're really, really good at the game, alright, bros, I'm talking about like
those 10% of you really good.
That are really good, and whenever they're entering a draft, they know they will win it. You know what I mean? Then it's really interesting to put maybe 20, 30 euros worth of FIFA points at the start of the game, at least. Because like that, you can play a draft. You can earn some packs. You can get better at the game. You see what I mean there? It's like, it's really important that if you're gonna play draft, because at the start of the game, 15,000 coins for a draft.
It's huge.
It's important.
It's huge.
15k at the start, bros, it's hell a lot. Whereas 350 points, I think it's like what? In terms of FIFA points, that's like what? 75 cents, €1, $1 maybe.
No.
Maybe more, 2 euros?
That's like 3 euros, 4 euros.
3 or 4 euros, okay then. Well, that's, yeah, when you talk about that money, it's kind of expensive. But you know what I mean? If you pack someone like, let's say, Davinson Sanchez, right at the start of a full draft, then you can sell him for like what? 50k. We don't know his price yet. The game is not coming out in a, like what? Next week. So we don't really know the price of the players at the start. But
yeah,
someone like him, someone like Anthony Martial, Heung-Min Son, you know what I mean? Those are the type of players that you can pack during a few draft rewards if you win the draft. So, you know, it's like interesting. Yeah. Sometimes it can be interesting.
After Buzz, this video, the main purpose of this video is just to clear up your mind and make yourself a good vision about what is it that you want in FIFA 19. Do you want to have a pay-to-win team, or do you want like a road to glory when you grind, when you prioritize grinding the game to have your team? It all depends on you. Yeah. Hopefully, guys, this video will be helpful for you. Don't forget 150 likes, and we can potentially say that this new series is a success. We can call it Should You. We can call it the Should You series or something like this.
The Twins Talk Show, you know what I mean? Maybe something, you guys figure it out in the comments.
Let us know in the comments, because this is like a discussion video. I just wanted to make really this video to just answer your question about Should You Buy FIFA Points. Hopefully it was helpful for you. With that being said, brothers, hopefully you're gonna have a good evening. And yes, for myself, my name is Vincent. As you can see, bros, I'm wearing the PSG jersey. In the next couple of days, Liverpool, PSG, we're going to make a special score prediction on that. And yeah, guys, my name is Vincent.
My name is Liam, bros. Hopefully you have enjoyed. If you have any question, or if you want to leave your comments, bros, honestly, leave your thoughts down there.
Yeah.
Let's have a discussion together. And yeah, make sure to share this video with your friend if you find it helpful. If you want to discuss with them about what we said. Share the video, bros. Spread the word around. Let's be a community in this, because
let's help each other out.
Let's help each other out. Exactly, bros. This is why we're making this video, because when there is real money involved, I mean, it's real money, bros.
It's business.
You eat with money. You live with without money. You know, it's like
you cannot
exactly.
Yeah, you're done.
Especially nowadays. So it's really important to talk about the subject. Depending whenever you're watching this video, it can be like in June of FIFA 19. You know what I mean? But hopefully this will have helped you a lot. If you have appreciated, let us know your comments, bros. If you dislike the video, you can dislike the video. Do whatever.
You feel it's needed.
Exactly. Exactly. So if you want to see more of these, let us know. With that being said, bros, have a good evening. Yeah, bros, talk to you guys tomorrow. With, once again, a double upload. Right now, bros, this is the moment where we grind for FIFA 19. We're going to do a Road to Glory. We didn't mention it, bros. Sorry if I talk a little bit too long right now, but we will do a Road to Glory for FIFA 19. So if you guys want to follow our journey, then make sure to subscribe. Make sure to subscribe, bros. It's really important. With notifications so that you guys can always be the first one. And honestly, that always makes me smile when you guys say first in the comment section. It's really good. It's really good to see. So, bros, make sure to subscribe with notifications if you want to see more of our videos. And yeah, I think I've said everything, bros.
Yeah, basically, guys, see you, bros, tomorrow for a new video.
Au revoir.